Good evening, guys. My name is Tommy, and welcome to Northern Ear Reactions. How are you? I hope you're all okay. Tonight, we have another Patreon request. They all come really thick and fast around the beginning of the month, because that's when everyone's Patreon renews. And this time, it is for brand new channel patron, Yuka. And Yuka has been in touch this week, and he has asked me to listen to Tony Williams, I think the guy is called. Tony Williams. It looks like he's a drummer, and the song that we're going to be listening to is called Red Alert. So, what has Yuka said about Tony Williams? He said, my first recommendation is Tony Williams. They call him the greatest drummer of all time, in tandem with Alan Holdsworth, a true pioneer. Accessible, infectiously groovy jazz rock with a touch of metal, dating back to 1975. So, that's exactly what we're going to listen to. This is Tony Williams, Red Alert. Let's just jump in and see what it's all about. Let's go.
Piano is all good.
was Tony Williams, Red Alert. Syncopation. That is all I can say. Throughout that whole song, everything was focused on the offbeat. That must have been incredibly difficult to play and to keep up for that length of time. That was really interesting because that was jazz that I really love listening to, but with really modern twists, like the heavily distorted guitar. I said it was an organ, but it's not an organ, it's keyboard. Normally with a traditional kind of jazz setup, they'd go through each of the instruments and each one would manage to get some kind of solo, if you like, in there. And there wasn't that tonight. You just had the guitar solo and then you had the keyboard solo. But that drummer was able to underpin everything and still show little glimpses of flair in between, whilst maintaining the syncopation throughout. And I know that the bass line was syncopated as well. That was off the beat as well. So that would have helped a little bit. But still, that was, there was times in there where I was just thinking, I can't even process what's happening because every single one of them was doing something special at one point. Just improv. True improv. What they would have done is to prepare for that. They would have known the structure of the song. They would have known what key they were playing in and what the main chord progression was, which actually wasn't very much of a chord progression. I think it only went up by a tone, maybe, or maybe even a semitone, and then came back down again pretty much throughout. So they would have had that basic structure of this is the key and this is the chord structure that we're going to play. But all those solos would have just been completely improvised on the spot. All those drum fills that you heard, all those little bass runs that you would have heard that connect all the little things together, they would have all been just made up. And that's what makes jazz so special. I know that you can say, oh my God, look at this band, they've got an amazing guitarist, the solo is amazing. But this is like, this is like freestyling almost. This is them in the moment feeling the song. And yeah, they might have the odd lick and the odd little run and stuff that's kind of embedded that they use every now and then. But a lot of that will have just, and this is what's great about jazz. You can listen to the same song, if you like, and it will never, ever, ever be the same. We could listen to another version of Red Alert. I could find another video of that and it would have the same structure, have the same chord progression. You know, you'd still have a guitar solo and a keyboard solo, but it would never be the same because the solo itself isn't set in stone. But just saying that, in my head, now I'm thinking to myself, how is that different from other genres? This might be a question for you guys, actually. Is there certain bands that record exactly what they played that day in the studio and that's just the kind of snapshot in time and that's what that song will sound like forever for all of the performances in the future? Or are there some bands that do change it up all the time and those instrumentals never sound the same? Let me know in the comment section because I think wider than Tony Williams, wider than jazz, wider than this video tonight, it's actually quite an interesting question. How many times does the solo that you hear on the day in the studio, which you could say is the musician feeling it and doing exactly what I've just said that jazz musicians do, they feel it and they play what they feel, but how many of those bands would then lock that in forever? So let me know, comment section. Yuka, thank you very much. This was really, really interesting, and actually this made a really nice change from the usual. That was Tony Williams with Red Alert. Thank you very much for suggesting it. Thank you very much for being a patron this month. I really do appreciate it. And guys, if you want to get involved, I will stick a link to the Patreon and the Discord in the description section. The Discord is where you can get involved with the chat with the other Northern Ear subscribers and general music fans. And the Patreon link is where you can get things like what Yuka's done and get your own personalized reaction to pretty much any song or video on YouTube, within reason. So if you're interested in that, check out the description section and the links will be there. Other than that, guys, I'll be back again tomorrow for some more reactions. Until then, have a good night, stay safe, and I'll see you soon. Take care.